Lately, I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes and we see what we've become, in the cold light of day, we're a flame in the wind, not the fire that we begun. Every argument, every word we can't take back.
At the tone, please record your message.
Hey Ferd, it's Suhail. Give me a call back. We're at the office. All three of us are here.
So we are trying to... We had a little bit of a hiccup on the exterior signage of our building. So we're trying to figure out... The initial plan was, can we make the entire outside of the Bucktown space? Can we paint the whole building black so it looks really clean? It's like a yellowish brick right now, and then just put like a Dentology sign. But what we ran into is the owner of the building wanted to use a paint that can be removed easily. And because the brick is glazed, you can't remove the, without priming the paint and damaging the brick, you can't paint the building. So now we had to completely scrap that idea and try to figure out how can we, within our budget, create something that's pretty impactful and not use paint. So basically build something on the exterior of the building to make it look really cool and really nice.
Say what's up to the family, man. It's been a while.
Hey guys, I know it's been a long time since we've, we've had an episode, and you know, we've been like super busy here, and we're trying to get everything wrapped up to open our third practice in January, and we have some cool things we're working on with Invisalign, which I know we haven't really talked a lot about, but that's taking up a lot of our time, and they're just building out our original practices and continue to hire and train. So we have a lot of things going on, and we're kind of moving at 1,000 miles per hour. But we're trying to get back on the groove of sharing as much content as we can. So hopefully you'll get a few more videos over the next couple of months, and we'll be able to kind of continue that flow.
Hey guys, so every week we tend to try to meet up, us three, the owners, so me, Suhail, and Hani, and then Karma, Director of Operations, go over every aspect of the office. When you first open a business, it is important always to have open communication and be as diligent as you can. It's just hard because you're just hitting the ground running, so you can't do as often. Now we make sure we pencil it in and we take our time doing it. So it does allow us to find little things that we may avoid otherwise, or things we could do better. That's what you guys are going to be watching today, us kind of doing the basic stuff that we have to do that's maybe not the funnest, but we gotta do it.
So as we transition, these meetings are gonna become a lot more important because we need to figure out how we can strategize the next step. What do we need to do in terms of staffing? What do we need to do in terms of structure? Making sure the doctor schedules are there. How do we promote the new practice in new locations? How do we fine tune systems and you know, regulations from an HR department standpoint? Obviously we're gonna have a much larger team. So we need to be a lot more structured and as far as from a compliance standpoint, which obviously we don't have HR backgrounds, so that's a lot of learning on our end and a lot of kind of, you know, growth on our end and kind of intrinsic analyzing. So that's a lot of stuff that we talk about during these Tuesday meetings, and then what we need to do from each department level to get there.
Where you have high expenditures and you're in growth phase, you know, keeping your cash flow, like managing cash flow, sometimes can be really challenging. So a lot of the things that what we do, you know, as a business, and you know, obviously this is like full transparency, is, you know, like at this level it takes all of us sometimes to think about how do we manage our cash flow and how do we, you know, pay things at certain points and be able to, you know, be able to do that in a timely manner. And I think that's the challenge, and most of that challenge falls on Osama and Karm. You know, I just like, you know, let them deal with the stress.
But it's good. We have the good thing is we have, the important thing is if you're growing quarter by quarter, year by year, that's one of the things we are very fortunate to actively do, that we have room for capacity. So if you're a business, the whole goal is to get it to be as optimal as you can be. So one, from a patient experience standpoint, that's ever evolving for us. But then two, for us as dentists and hygienists, it's to get that as optimal as we can be. So we're actually only maybe at around 80% capacity here. And even in Streeterville, we're lucky if we're at 80% as well. So our goal is if we get those to 100%, then we'll get to see more of the fruits of the labor that can then transfer to future offices that we can take care of.
The problem with having large practices is your overhead stays the same, your fixed costs are the same, and the longer you are not at capacity, the more your expenses are high and the profit margins or the growth, the amount you spend to get to growth or to get to capacity is higher. So obviously cash flow tends to be challenging because how do I equip this next chair? I need to add a lot more staff in order to staff this new doctor. So a lot of that's overhead and the taxes you pay on that is cash flow that has to be accounted for. And once you hit capacity, those fixed costs don't change and you're saturated, so your profit margins are higher. And that obviously increases cash flow, so it becomes less of a problem. You reach capacity a lot faster, obviously, in a 2,500 square foot practice than you would in a 7,000 square foot practice. So that's the challenge that we are trying to find. What is our sweet spot? Bucktown is going to be our litmus test as to what our footprint is going to be in the future, and to see if that is our sweet spot, or do we need to go somewhere in between the at 8 to 10 ops. So we're still kind of learning as we go and trying to figure out what's going to be the best way to go.
The last year, to kind of give you an idea of, we started realizing this about a year ago and saying, okay, how do we get to capacity in South Loop? How do we get to capacity in Streeterville? And we knew right away it was actually adding doctors, right? That was like the number one thing that was preventing us from being able to reach that capacity, because we are seeing about 700 new patients a month. So the patient flow is there. And I think for us, it's, can we continue to add doctors to be able to manage that patient flow and bring in more production and bring, be able to reach that capacity. So to give you an idea, we were, 50 to 60% of the top line revenue maybe a year ago. And we've added on about 6 to 7 doctors, and we've just added 2 more in the last like 2 or 3 weeks. And from that point, now we're at about, Hanny, Sam, and I are only about 15% of the top line revenue. So our goal is to be, 5% or less of that top line revenue, and eventually in that practice, so we're handling more of the management side of the business.
That won't be out of choice. We kind of have to. Yeah. We're already, if we really wanted to, we would be able to do it now in terms of have to handle a lot of the behind the scenes stuff. Running a place that has 60 to 65 employees, it takes a lot. And it's trying to build a certain culture, you're working with partners, you're working with management, so it requires a lot of hands in there. And we're also very particular. We also are looking for something that we're trying to grow, and it's not just to grow anything. So a little attention to details too.
So I know we were talking about like a lot of the stress of like managing the practice at this level, but just to kind of leave it at a positive note, October, which is traditionally like a pretty slow month in dentistry, it was our best month that we've ever done at Dentology. And a lot of that is because we're starting to see a lot of the investments that we put into hiring new doctors, come into fruition. We're also really excited to show you guys Bucktown. So next week, we're gonna have Lawrence out, and he's gonna be filming, and we're gonna show you exactly what Bucktown looks like. So we're gonna walk through that. We're gonna work on a lot of cool stuff from the website, and another really cool thing that we've always kept under wraps is like things that we're working on with Invisalign. So sorry, we're not there yet. We can't share that yet with you guys, but we will very soon. So a lot of super exciting things that are happening, and hopefully, we want to keep you guys, up to date and keep this as real as possible. So we'll keep you guys in the loop, and we'll go from there. So we'll see you guys soon. If you guys want to hear something in particular from us, like what are your challenges in marketing? What are your challenges with finance? What are your challenges with hiring? Let us know. Even we're open to everything or any type of suggestions that you guys have. But if you like our video, follow our page, share it on your social, or even just subscribe to our YouTube. So we'll see you guys soon.